So we're talking about aging. So growing older is awesome, right? It means, I mean, for one, that you're living, but you're hopefully getting wiser, you're collecting memories. But what we don't want is that growing older to show on the outside so much. So there's a term that came from a study that came out of Italy, published in the journals of gerontology, that used the term inflammaging. So inflammaging is the combination between aging and inflammation. So what does inflammation have to do with it? So aging is constituted by a chronic low-grade inflammation. And this inflammation is being linked to the cause of so many diseases, age-related or not, as well as a huge risk factor for morbidity. And both in the larger view, concerns like atherosclerosis, arthritis, diabetes, but also on those surface level concerns of aging, such as wrinkles or excess fat. So when talking about inflammation, that can sound kind of abstract. So what exactly are we talking about here? So inflammation in an acute phase, such as an injury or an infection, is good, so it's helpful to help heal your body. But what we don't want is this to become a chronic systemic inflammation. This can damage cells, improperly activate your immune system, and damage tissues like that, the skin around your eyes. So how do we prevent inflammaging? We need to look at those obvious outside stressors. So, you know, handling your work, life balance, your relationships. But internally, there's a few different systems that we do need to focus on. For one, our detoxification pathways. So both your kidneys and your liver, your bowels, we want to make sure that they are filtering those bad guys properly. We're getting things out. We're flushing it out. We aren't reabsorbing it. We also want to have a strong gut microbiome. So as I've talked about and how you know, that gut bacteria is so important to many different systems in your body. So we want to have a happy balance of good gut bacteria. We want to eradicate any infections as well as build up that mucosal wall so that we have a proper barrier. So we know 70-80% of your immune system is within your gut. So going into that, that third system is your immune system. So we want to have that strong immune system and not improperly triggering it. So from things like foods that you're sensitive to or intolerant to, as well as taking care of any chronic exposures, things like heavy metals, any infections, parasitic or bacterial, viral, any nutrient deficiencies, and of course balancing your blood sugar, which is a huge part of all of this. So next time you catch yourself saying, I'm feeling old, I want you to really think about what you're doing about this, taking control of your health, and if you're really preventing that inflammaging.